I've been on a quest to find the best tubeless sealants for 20 years now, and today I'm excited to be sharing my findings. To find the best and worst products, I scoured the internet for every independent sealant puncture test, analysed the data, and then purchased the products that showcased the best performance. I then extensively tested them on various bike journeys across countries and continents. The data reveals the sealants to avoid too, so you won't make the mistake of buying the poor performing products. But first, what exactly is tubeless sealant and how does it work? Tubeless sealant is a liquid that sloshes around in the empty space between your tire and your rim. This liquid replaces a typical bicycle inner tube, creating an airtight seal inside your tire. Sealant also repairs small punctures while you ride, often without you knowing. When a puncture occurs, the air pressure inside your tire pushes the sealant towards the puncture site. Through both a chemical and physical process, the sealant will clot the hole after being exposed to the outside air. Small, suspended particles inside the sealant are designed to create additional surface area for the liquid base to clot around. This clotting process can very impressively repair holes of up to 6 or 7 millimeters in your tire. Sealant also plays an important role in keeping the airtight seals between your tire and rim, as well as around your valve. Okay, for those who don't want to watch the full video, here are the 4 best performing products. Orange Seal Regular achieves amazing results on mountain bike tires with pressures under 35 psi, and many people seem to have success with it at higher pressures too. Peaty's Holeshot Biofibre tests best for gravel and road bike tires with pressure above 35 psi. Stan's Original tests very well for pressures under 35 psi and is commonly available in shops. And lastly, Stan's Race Day tests best across high and low pressures, but it doesn't last as long in your tires. As promised, here are 6 poor performing products according to the data. Hex Sealant tested 8th out of 8 in 2 different low pressure tire tests. Maxima Sealant tested 10th and 11th out of 11 products in some low pressure tire tests. Bontrager Sealant tested 12th and 14th out of 14 products in some low pressure tire tests. Hutchison and Weldtite rank 15th and 17th out of 17 at gravel bike tire pressure. And surprisingly, Silka Ultimate Sealant, which is quite popular here on YouTube, doesn't test well. In a gravel tire test, it was one of 2 sealants that failed to seal a puncture in a field of 17 products. And in a mountain bike tire test, it ranked 6th and 7th out of 11 products. Keep in mind, these tests are conducted more than a month after installation. So while you might have seen Silka perform well after a fresh installation, it doesn't rank at the top after a month of riding. If you want to analyse the data for yourself, you'll find handy tables of 33 different tyre sealants on cyclingabout.com. How do we benchmark sealant performance? The best way to benchmark different tyre sealants is to punch holes of different sizes into a tyre and see which sealants can repair the puncture. If the repair is successful, we can measure the air loss. The sealant with the least air loss for a given hole size is regarded as the best. I prefer tests that have been conducted more than 1 month after the sealant has been installed. This tests the sealant's performance after it has dried and degraded a bit, which is a more realistic riding circumstance than a fresh installation. Tests in a laboratory are the most accurate at taking measurements. However, they do not take into account the forces on the tyre while riding. Tyres will stretch and pull apart while riding, especially under cornering loads. So I think that outdoor tests provide a more realistic impression of sealant performance, even if the measurements are less accurate. Why does sealant usually use latex? Latex is an extremely stretchy material that, even in small quantities, can hold back liquid and air. There are other alternatives to latex, but they almost always test to be less effective. How long does sealant last? Most sealants are effective inside your tyres for between 2 and 5 months. How long the sealant lasts depends on many factors, including how often you ride, how much has escaped through punctures, the temperatures and humidity in your area, and the brand and model of sealant and the tyres that you are using. With some sealants, you'll find dried latex inside the tyres after a few months, as the additives will have evaporated from the formula. With other sealants, you'll find the latex has been absorbed by the tyre, leaving just the additives. Some tubeless sealants will stay liquid for longer, as they are formulated with higher percentages of additives. But performance takes a hit. They are thinner and take longer to coagulate around punctures. What temperature range does tubeless sealant work in? Most tyre sealants will perform between minus 10 and plus 50 degrees Celsius. However, some sealants have been specially formulated to perform well right down at minus 30 degrees Celsius. Can you use CO2 cartridges with tubeless sealant? CO2 cartridges can be used with tubeless sealant in emergencies. However, if the cold blast of gas goes directly into the sealant, it can cause lumps inside latex-based sealants. Make sure to only inflate your tyre with the air valve at the top position. Exposure to CO2 for multiple days can cause your sealant to degrade. If you inflate with CO2, make sure to replace it with regular air as soon as possible. Can you refresh sealant through the valve? Thinner sealants can be refreshed through the air valve. I think Stans makes the best bottles for doing this. Sealants with larger, suspended particles are not suitable for valve installations. Instead, you will need to break the tyre bead from the rim or risk the valve clogging. Can you use tubeless sealant with high-pressure tyres? Most tubeless sealants will repair small holes in road bike tyres. However, when it comes to larger punctures, the data suggests that performance varies significantly between different brands. When we analyse the properties of sealants that perform best on road bike tyres, it's clear there should be large suspended particles in the sealant to clot the larger holes. These particles can seal a big hole in a high-pressure tyre with little air loss. Why does tubeless sealant seep through tyre sidewalls? This is the latex part of the sealant getting soaked up by tyres with porous sidewalls. It will eventually stop when the tyre is airtight. The good news is that tyre companies are getting better at reducing seeping, but expect tyres with very thin, supple sidewalls to be most prone to this phenomenon. If you notice this in your tyres, make sure to add 30 millilitres of sealant after a few days. This replaces any latex lost and will ensure your sealant can perform properly. Which products were puncture tested to find the best tubeless sealants? I assessed the data from these 33 tubeless sealant products. Let's now take a closer look at the best 4 sealant products. The best tubeless sealant for mountain bike tyres is Orange Seal Regular. This thin sealant performs extremely well in all independent tests, resulting in very little air loss on punctures of all sizes. Orange Seal Regular is one of few sealants that can genuinely seal up a huge hole without you even getting off your bike. Orange Seal Regular films your tyre in the first month, so expect around 50% of the liquid to be lost in this process. This makes it a top sealant for thin, porous tyres. The remaining liquid lasts between 1 and 3 months longer, depending on the environmental conditions. When we look at the mountain bike tyre puncture tests, Orange Seal Regular has some seriously impressive puncture repair characteristics. In every puncture test I could find, this sealant closed the puncture sites with very little pressure loss. Even with a 6mm cut, there was just 3 PSI lost. few sealants can master that test. Interestingly, amongst people I know and trust, Orange Seal Regular works well at gravel and road bike pressures too. However, the data doesn't appear to back this up, so your results may vary. It's worth noting the endurance version of Orange Seal will last significantly longer in your tyres, and there's even a sub-zero version that's formulated for extremely cold temperatures. The downside to these sealant formulations is that you trade off some sealing performance. According to the Bicycling Magazine data, endurance is okay at dealing with small holes, but not so good when it comes to bigger holes. Keep in mind, you can mix Orange Seal Regular and Orange Seal Endurance together if you want to trade a bit of performance for some longevity. The best performing sealant for gravel and road tyres is Peaty's Holeshot Biofibre. This sealant is thicker than other sealants on this list, especially those with a latex base. It contains lots of suspended particles, which results in a product best suited to road and gravel bike tyres with higher pressures. The particulate is highly visible inside Peaty's sealant. These biodegradable particles are made from starches and cellulose that have been sourced from eucalyptus plantations. In contrast to other products, Peaty's claims that their sealant is compatible with CO2, and despite the sealant being quite thick, it can still be installed through the air valve. According to the data, Peaty's outperforms all other sealants at road and gravel bike tyre pressures. When stabbed with a thick 1.5mm nail, Peaty's sealant lost just 1 psi from a starting pressure of 87 psi. The tyre then later held 101 psi with its repair. In the off-road CC test, it repaired a 5mm cut at 40 psi with just 0.1 psi lost. Peaty's is less impressive at lower tyre pressures, so I'd recommend some of the other sealant options for lower pressures. Another great sealant that's available everywhere is Stan's Original, which works very well at air pressures in the 15 to 40 psi range. This sealant's performance is great for any smaller cuts to your mountain or gravel bike tyres. But for bigger cuts in the 4 to 6mm size range, it doesn't perform as well, so you might need to use a plug. A huge advantage to Stan's Original is that it's one of the runniest sealants available. This makes it easy to install through your valve and easy to syringe out of your tyres as well, which is great for tyre swaps. Stan's Original also lasts longer than most. When I recently opened up my tyres after cycling for 4 months in hot conditions, there was still sealant in its liquid form and no dried latex to be seen. I should note that Stan's also manufacture Schwalbe Dock Blue sealant, and based on the data, it has to be a near identical formula. Stan's Original falls flat when it comes to sealing tyres at high road bike pressures. In one test, it lost 77 out of 87 psi, and when the tyre was inflated back up, this repair could not hold high pressure. There is a Stan sealant that can deal with high-pressure road bike tyres, and that's Stan's Race Day. This sealant uses twice as much particulate as Original, which allows it to seal big holes with the least air loss. It's one of the very few that can top Orange Seal Regular in the mountain bike puncture tests. It came in first place in multiple mountain bike puncture tests, losing just 0.2 to 0.4 psi in the small cut tests. When it came to bicycling's 4mm puncture test, it lost only 3 psi, which is a clear step up in performance compared to Stan's Original. Additionally, Stan's Race Day lost 1.2 psi in the gravel tyre test and was able to seal a road bike tyre very effectively. One downside to Stan's Race Day is that the high amount of particulate can clog your air valve. As a result, it must be installed directly into the tyre and over the bead. This sealant also dries out quicker than most. Some people report zero liquid in just 1 month in hot conditions, which puts this sealant in the high maintenance category. In my own test, it lasted over 2 months. That said, Stan's race day and original can be mixed. So perhaps a 50-50 or 70-30 mix of the two would provide a better balance between high performance and longevity. When we inspect the puncture test data, the best sealants rise to the top. If you'd like to try out any of these sealants, consider using the purchase links below, as it's no cost to you and is a great way to support this channel. Orange Seal Regular stands out as best at low tire pressures. It closes small holes with minimal air loss and, impressively, seals big cuts with just a few PSI missing. Stan's race day is even higher performing in some tests, but the downside is that it doesn't last as long. It also can't be installed through the valve, which will be a deal breaker to some. That said, it performs very well with high pressure road tires. Peaty's Holeshot Biofibre loses the least air pressure in all gravel and road pressure puncture tests. It also lasts a long time and can be installed through the valve. And last but not least, Stan's original is cheap, long-lasting, and an all-round performer for tyre pressures under 35 psi. The best bit is that you'll find it in stores everywhere. I'll see you guys soon.